one more time for Lady Ha-Ha. Give her a round of applause. There she goes. Hello. Well, I am so excited to be here. This is my favorite comedy club in the world. I love coming to this place. The punchliner, you know, it's really... So I flew in yesterday, and I get on the plane, and I notice there's a female pilot. Exactly. It's a female pilot, and I'm a comedian. I'm thinking, oh, here's a chance to have some fun. You should get the hat and the wings. I said, excuse me, so you're a pilot, right? She says, yes, I'm flying a plane here. I said, cool. I said, well, there's a guy in there. They call it a cockpit, right? So what do they call it when you're in there? I figured I got it, right? She looked at me and said, box office. I am an idiot. I got this aquarium at home a couple of weeks ago to the fish store. I paid $85. I figured I'd stock with some unusual fish. You know, so I paid $85 for a blowfish. What a ripoff. You guys are laughing. I had my dick in the tank for 2 hours. Nothing. I am an idiot. Last week I'm watching TV. I'm eating a bag of M&M's, and that old commercial came into my brain. You know the one I'm talking about? Melts in your mouth, not in your hand. And I'm thinking to myself, how does that happen? How do they know? How do they know your mouth, your hand? How do they know the difference? You know, I was out to prove a point. I figured I was going to put them in warm places they'd never been before. So I took some, put them between my toes, but they didn't melt. I took some, put them under my arms. They still didn't melt. Then I grabbed a handful, put them down my crotch. That blew their mind. They melted everywhere. Only problem, next day, my wife is doing the laundry. She held up my underwear and said, look, I know what these brown stains are. You want to explain these green brown stains? A couple of weeks ago, we're over at my wife's brother's house. That's my brother-in-law, right? And his wife is in the bedroom getting ready, and the three of us are sitting on the couch. It's my wife, her brother, and me. We're sitting on the couch, and she's taking forever to get ready. And we got reservations at a restaurant for 4, you know, and I'm getting pissed off because we're running late. And finally, after seeing what seemed like an eternity, she comes out of the bedroom. She's got a big rip in the back of her pantyhose. And she bends over, and she says, look at the size of this. I don't know, something came over me. So I just said, wow, that is fucking huge. And you know you got a big rip in your pantyhose. Because I'm pissed off. I'm pissed off about the gas prices. Is it just me? No, no. But I got an idea. I got a solution. If we could ever do this, it would work. We'd never need another drop of oil. All we got to do is figure out how to make cars run on urine. We'd never run out, and I would love the models. It'd be like the Toyota Leaf. The Nissan Pisser. Or that little French car, the Peugeot Oui-Oui. And I would love the slogan, you know, your wallet will be fatter when you empty your bladder. The car will run like a dream on a city stream. You'll get there quick with a loaded dick. So I'm a big sports fan. Do we have any sports fans out there? Sports. There's some sports I don't understand, though. Here's one I don't get. Curling. Have you seen this shit? Some guy's pushing a crock pot down the ice. Some asshole in front of it sweeping. Not a sport, that's housework. Drag racing. I was watching drag racing on ESPN. Sucks. 3.8 seconds, it's over. You drop something, you miss everything. You'd be like, wow, this is it. Top Fuel eliminated. I'm waiting all day for this. Oh, fuck, it dropped me program. Damn! I like basketball. I used to just don't like the coaches, the NBA coaches. You know, they wear those $1,000 Armani suits, $500 silk ties, $800 leather shoes. They look like they're ready to do a GQ layout. God forbid you call a foul on one of the players. They use the sidelines like it's the runway of a fashion show. The biggest offender ever in the history of basketball was Pat Riley when he was with the Lakers in the Heat. Remember this guy? He was perfect. And I was watching a game one time, and they called a foul on one of his players. It was like, foul on the 33 Alonzo Mourning.
I was like, foul on Mourning?
Never even touched him. That's what cheered me up. So I was at this county fair and I saw a guy selling barbed wire. How do you make a living selling barbed wire? Is there anybody in this room in the last 6 months that purchased barbed wire? Make a noise. Of course not. You cannot possibly make a living. Who's buying barbed wire? It's like, honey, little Tommy keeps trying to climb out of his crib. Oh, really? I'll fix that little fucker. There's a man on a barbed wire and keep his ass in there. So I'm watching Animal Planet. This really pissed me off. I'm watching Animal Planet, and I had two lions out on a hunt, and they're hunting down a herd of 10,000 wildebeest. And the wildebeest are running for their life with these two lions. Jake gets so pissed off, he yelled at the screen. I was furious. I'm like, hey, hey, turn around and beat the shit out of those two lions. It's 5,000 to 1. You got a shot at it. But they didn't listen, you know? They got one of the lions away. They got one of the wildebeest away from the herd. They had a lion on each side, you know? And the wildebeest knew he's in trouble, you know, because the camera came in and he's like, oh, fuck! You can't believe this shit! 9,999 other ones, they gotta pick me! They started eating everything, you know? And then the guy said, here comes the scavengers. A big vulture flew around. And then a jackal came up. Then another bird came down. The guy said, this is a guinea fowl. Folks, I'm Italian. I'm not real comfortable with that term. But it's okay. They showed a close-up of the bird. He had gold chains, pleated pants, shiny shoes. And an attitude. He's like, yo, lion, I'm starving over here. Hey, come on. So I'll tell you what else is pissing me off now. So they want to take God out of the Pledge of Allegiance. Is that pissing anybody off? And then they're talking about they want to take it off the money. Yeah, pretty soon you won't even be able to say God. You got to take down the nativity scene. Pretty soon you won't even be able to say God. It's going to suck for me, because when I'm having sex and I reach that big orgasm, what the hell can I possibly yell out? And I'll be like, natural selection! Ah, intelligent design. Yeah, I just wonder about you. Hey, here's another thing that gets me. Why do they call men's testicles nuts? In reality, they look like figs. Should we call them figs? Ah, shit, it just hit me in the face. So how's the food so far? Good? Yeah. Yeah, good? Yeah. So I like to eat on the ship. I enjoy eating on the ship. You know, you go to the restaurant, you eat, it's nice, it's cool, you know? I don't like doing it on the road, because I'm usually by myself, and I gotta walk in there and deal with that maitre d' every fucking time we go in there, you know? Yeah, I walk in there, he's like, oh, can you see anybody behind me, you asshole? Come on, come on! Don't do that. They'll look at even later. I was waiting for my table. I heard this.
Is your party on?
And then laying the food pretty, you know, and then with the stupid questions, and yeah, it's like, would you like to see a menu? No, I'm gonna randomly guess it. I'm gonna go with some poached platypus. You got some of that? The food pretty, so you are. You know, my waiter came over and said, tonight on a special is angel hair pasta. Angel hair pasta, soft, delicate, gentle, make sure I order it. I mean, if they named pasta after any other hair, I don't think you even think about it. Well, am I wrong? I mean, if the waiter came over and said, tonight our special is pubic hair pasta. I think I'm going to go with the rice, yeah. Hey, come on, guys. Even if you did order the pubic hair pasta, you know it would work. You know what would happen halfway through the meal, you'd be like... Check, please. Look at the ladies laughing at this shit. Oh my God, look at them. Like they've never been there, right, guys? You guys are just a little more subtle. The ladies are a little more subtle, you know what I'm saying? Hey, honey, you okay? I thought I heard. Yeah, but I thought I heard. Are you sure that you shut the fuck up? I'm trying to give you a phone job. Shut the fuck up. I don't know. You guys are funny, chair, man. Yeah, because I'm out there. I see you. I watch you. You know, you're cute. I watch you talk. That's what I do. I watch people. That's how I get my stuff. I just watch people. And you say the cute little words, the words that you like, you know, little simple words. This one you like a lot. Oops, you love that word. I love using it. Oops, you know, I drop my keys. Oops, I forgot my phone. Oops. Right, but if it's a little more severe than dropping your keys, it's not oops anymore, right? I mean, slam your fingers in a car door. Guaranteed it's not oops. I'd be like, oh, fuck. This one the ladies like. Ladies, you love this one. Ta-da! I love that. You're trying a new dress, you come out. Ta-da! Bake a cake and bring it up. Ta-da! Just once, I want to be making love to my wife and give it to her so good that she reaches that magic moment and just yells out, ta-da! This is one of the guys use. Guys, you like this one. Aha. Because guys think they're smart. You figured it out. We know. We figured it out. Aha. We got it. We got it. Aha. See, but you wouldn't use that either. You come home and you see your wife getting doggy style by your best friend, you're not going to go, aha. I'm guaranteed he won't go, oops. Just hope she's not yelling, ta-da! Dinner time. So I gotta tell you this, I just moved into my new condo. Thank you. But I got a little problem. I got a problem with me. I'm not allowed to have a dog that weighs over 50 pounds. So my Saint Bernard is really pissed off. Because I shave it and make him look skinnier. Then I told the condo association he was a greyhound who just let himself go.